Auditeurs. Because we need Justice Ginsburg to stay and continue to dissent to any and all nonsense perpetuated by orange people living in White Houses. So we're gonna play some awesome beats, hang out, sign the official birthday card that's going to be delivered from Brooklyn to DC to the notorious RBG.
Thank you. Happy birthday to a great Supreme Court Justice. A little shower will not stop us. We want to clearly celebrate just such an important person in our history and a symbol of women's right and the fight for equality in this country. We really want to thank all of our partners that joined us in this initiative. I'm going to list off some of them and then come back to them after our speakers. We want to start with B Cake New York. Where's that cake? See that cake over there? The great design. She provided the amazing looking cake to celebrate Justice Ginsburg's birthday. Assemblywoman Joanne Simon, State Senator Brian Kavanaugh, Brooklyn Civil Court Judge Patria Frias Colon, that's the first elected Dominican-born judge. Brooklyn Civil Court Judge Connie Melendez, the first Cuban-born elected judge. New York Supreme Court Justice Doris Lynn Cohen, the first woman of Asian descent to be appointed to an appellate panel in New York State. Give it up. and all of our elected partners and our initial partners in support of this renaming campaign. The excitement has really crisscrossed the entire borough of Brooklyn, and we just wanted to mention some of them. Wayne Rosenfeld, East Meadow Jewish Center, Deborah Swartz, Brooklyn Historical Society, Regina Myers, Downtown Brooklyn Partnership, Martha Camber, YWCA Brooklyn, James Madison High School, the alumni for Justice Ginsburg, Brooklyn Heights Association, Brooklyn Bar Association, League of Women Voters, Long Island University, Brooklyn Bar Association Volunteer Lawyers Project, now NYC, Planned Parenthood of NYC, Brooklyn Law School, NYU Tandem School of Engineering, District Council 37, and Brooklyn Music School on 2019 Women's History Month to celebrate the 86th birthday. This great Supreme Court justice has adorned a black robe on the Supreme Court. Now it's time for her to have her name adorn the municipal building in the borough where she was born, Brooklyn, USA. This is an exciting moment for all of us when we think about Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg's legacy and legend. She was born in Brooklyn, March 15, 1933. No other place to be born than a place like Brooklyn. She's the daughter of Celia and Nathan Banda. Her father was a Jewish immigrant from Ukraine, while her mother was born in New York to Australian Jewish parents. Justice Ginsburg grew up in Flatbush, attended the East Meadow Jewish Center, and as I stated, she attended James Madison High School, graduated with a bachelor's from Cornell, and the first in her class at Columbia Law School. She became the first tenured woman in Columbia Law School, teaching there from 1972 to 1980 and co-authoring the first law school casebook on sex discrimination. She always had it right by advocating for women's rights. She knew then what we knew now, that is one of the biggest fights we're having in this country about women's rights. She co-founded the Women's Rights Law Reporter in 1970, the first American law journal to focus exclusively on women's rights. She was the director of the ACLU's Women's Rights Project. She argued a number of gender discrimination cases before the Supreme Court, and that was a signal of her great accomplishment and that was to come. In 1980, Jimmy Carter nominated her to a seat on the United States Court of Appeals for the District of Columbia Circuit. She served there until Bill Clinton nominated Justice Ginsburg to become the second woman to serve on the nation's highest court and the first of Jewish heritage. 2016, she surpassed former Associate Justice Louis Brandeis' longevity to become the longest serving Jewish justice in Supreme Court history. She's a three-time cancer survivor and one of the strongest women in the United States, with two children that she had with her late husband Martin and also a grandmother of four. We launched this campaign several months ago with a letter to the mayor de Blasio, who has the complete authority to make this happen. This falls in line with what his wife looked at as the first lady to how do we ensure the inclusiveness of statues and buildings that is reflective of the complete diversity of the city. And this campaign started off with such a loud bang with so many people, but we had so many elected officials who came on board and shared this important endeavor. Nearly every member of the Brooklyn State elected official delegation followed with a letter on their own in November. And today we want to honor the 86th birthday of Justice Ginsburg with close to 90,000 signatures. This is a legal legend and deserves to be recognized in this borough. We want to thank all of you for coming out and sending a long message and a loud message. Justice Ginsburg is welcoming this. She's happy, the home of her birth. There's something about being born in Brooklyn. I don't know what it is. But no matter where you go, it can be in Washington, D.C., on the Supreme Court, no greater honor than having your name placed on the on the building, in the municipal building, one of the most important cities. We don't consider ourselves a borough. This is the third largest city in America, and this is the greatest honor. The only other time she was more happy was when she was appointed to the Supreme Court. We're going to make her happy again on her 86th birthday. Happy birthday, Justice Ginsburg.
Yeah.
And we want to continue to see great success from her for a long time. We want her on the Supreme Court. State Senator Kavanaugh.
Thank you very much. I was not born in Brooklyn, but I'm very proud to represent a significant chunk of Brooklyn, and I'm very proud of the great leadership of our borough president, Eric Adams, and particularly this really inspired idea that he has to name this building right behind us after Ruth Bader Ginsburg. You know, this is a moment in our history when I think we are particularly aware of the need for jurists and lawyers and really all of us to stand up for the basic principles of equality, the basic principles of the rule of law in this country. But we don't name buildings after people who just shine in a moment. We name buildings after people whose legacy we understand is long-lasting, is enduring, and really is shaping the way we live our lives. Ruth Bader Ginsburg is such a person.
And I also want to give a big shout out to Brooklyn, because you have embraced this amazing, phenomenal task that we need to get done. And that is recognizing this amazing trailblazer, not just locally or even nationally, but I think internationally, given what she has provided for all the women and all the people of this country and, quite frankly, of this nation.
So,
thank you, Borough President Eric L. Adams, for making this happen.
Good morning. I am so happy to be here with you, supporting this great cause. We must get Ruth Bader Ginsburg's name erected on this building. I am especially proud and humbled to be here, as I am a first, as she was. And my love for her and my admiration for Ruth Bader Ginsburg starts when I was very young. I knew she opened doors for women, and she made my election possible and my ability and my doors open so that I may be a civil court judge. And I, in turn, help the people and the communities of Brooklyn. So I'm very happy to be here. I'm very proud of this moment. We must get this done. And happy birthday, Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Let's see your name on this building. Thank you.
I want some of my great signs. Those of you with signs, come on down front. If you're not camera shy, come on and let folks see those great signs. Who's that Ruth sign? Come on down. Happy birthday to Ruth. We haven't even started singing yet. Come right down front. Right down front. There we are. There we are. There we are. That's right.
It's a privilege to celebrate her birthday with all these wonderful people. Thank you very much, Borough President, for hosting all of us.
Thank you. A few more speakers that we don't want to forget, as we are in the downtown area where the building will sit. We want to thank and ask to say a few words, Regina Meyer from the Downtown Brooklyn Partnership.
Thank you, Borough President Eric Adams. I'm thrilled to be a part of this birthday celebration. Brooklyn is the center of our urban movement, and the renaming of the wonderful municipal building for Justice Ginsburg would really be a wonderful symbol for our entire borough. So happy birthday, Justice Ginsburg.
Thank you. And representing the YWCA from Brooklyn, Martha Camber.
All of you, I'm so delighted to be here. It is Women's History Month. It couldn't be more appropriate. The confluence of Justice Ginsburg's birthday with this particular moment in time. I want to thank Borough President Adams for this very brilliant idea. This building needs the inspiration of Justice Ginsburg. She represents everything that we care about in terms of democracy, equity, women's gender issues, all of the things that this woman has thought so carefully about and really helped to fight. The world around us, which is in quite a state at the moment, we need the thoughtful, careful, deep deep work that she is doing on the Supreme Court, and we're so grateful to have her there. I just want to say that at the Brooklyn Historical Society, we often turn our attention to not the most famous people in the world. We are constantly trying to shine a light on all of you, on the people of the borough of Brooklyn, who have really made this borough the great place that it is. Every once in a while, there is a very public figure, a very important superhero that we know needs to be front and center in the stories of Brooklyn. And today we certainly have found one. Thank you all for being here. Thank you, Borough President.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So we are extremely excited, and we want to send a strong message out to the mayor to let's name this building after Justice Ginsburg. It is time to do so right downtown in the heart of Brooklyn. We're at the best part of it. We're going to now cut our cake. Is this a vegan cake? Wow, that smells good. we're gonna do a nice happy birthday, you know, all right?
One minute.
All right, let's do a happy birthday.
Where's Justice Cologne? Patrick Cologne?
Clear as heat.